Welcome back, all you clever people. Justin here from Clever Tagline, and while I've got some really cool HitFilm stuff to share, I've also got to begin with a bit of a confession. Not long after I started my channel, I posted a very short tutorial about how to zoom in on a tracked subject. While it's had a lot of views, it's also had a lot of comments, with several of them pointing out that I glossed over certain concepts, that I just went through it too quickly in general. And you know what? They're totally right. If I could go back to my early channel self and tell them to fix that stuff, I would. Instead, I'm here to make it right. And I'm hoping that why don't we
get started.
Before we dive into HitFilm, we need to talk about shooting your footage. As the saying goes, garbage in, garbage out. To that end, here are three things to note when shooting with this effect in mind. The higher the resolution of your source footage, the more you can zoom in on the feature you're tracking. For example, if you plan to output to 1080p, try to shoot in 4K if possible. That gives you more room to zoom before the image becomes soft and pixelated. I strongly recommend recording with a high shutter speed. Now, this will require more light, but in the end, you'll have cleaner frames with less motion blur. Less motion blur means that it should be easier to track in HitFilm, and you won't have strange blurred frames in the middle of otherwise clear footage if the camera happens to move quickly. And speaking of camera motion, now part of what we're doing is automatically steadying the camera, but we still want the camera to be relatively stable, partly to avoid those random blurs, but also so that the feature we're tracking doesn't go too close to the edge of the frame. We'll see an example of this one later on. I'm going to walk you through two examples showing two different techniques and talk about all three of these principles along the way, all with the help of HitFilm Express version 14 and some free stock footage from pexels.com. If you'd like a project file with the example footage, you'll find it in the description below. Here's the first clip we're going to play with. This was originally shot at a high frame rate, but I decided I wanted things to move closer to real time, so I sped it up. I'm using the 4K version for this demo, but you'll also find a 1080p version in the project files. We're going to start with tracking. Right-click on the media bin item and choose Make Composite Shot. Expand the layer properties. Click the plus sign next to the track section to add a new track. Now zoom in with the mouse wheel to see the tracking boxes. The red box is used to mark the feature you want to track. Areas of strong contrast help define features more clearly. The green box is used to mark the area where HitFilm will search for that marked feature when it moves to the next or previous frame. Okay, I'm going to move this out, drag this tracking box, but clicking inside the red box here, I can drag both boxes and drag that up over the ear. I want to track just that spot right on the ear. I want the feature area here to be right on top of this black dot on top of the earbud, but I'm going to expand the box until it encompasses a bit more this area here, including this bit of contrast on the left side of the earbud. Now, because I know I have a lot of movement in various parts of this shot, I'm going to drag the green box out a lot wider so it's able to find those movements, I hope, a little bit more easily. Once these are both set, I'm going to go ahead and hit track forward and hope for the best. Okay, found a first stopping point here. So something in these last couple frames. So let me kind of shuffle back here and see. It's tracking pretty well, staying on that dark spot there with our center feature point there. But on this frame here, I think we just have a bit too much motion blur going from this frame into this frame, and it's lost the contrast, therefore lost an idea of what that feature actually looks like on this frame. So for this one, I'll zoom in and just drag the box again inside on top of where I think that should be in the blurred version of the video there. We'll back out a bit and continue tracking forward. Okay, it's still losing out on some things here. I might not actually have our search box big enough. It's going actually a pretty wide area here, and it's even lost it from here to here. So on this frame, it should be a bit farther up, probably about in there. Now let me just try tracking forward one frame, see if it finds it. No, it's still lost it there. So this may just be a case of the tracking box, the search area might not be big enough. So you may need to enlarge the size of the box at various points depending on what's happening in the shot. So in this case, I'll manually once again drag that over where I feel it should be on top of that feature. I'll just try tracking forward one frame at a time with this button here. And I didn't find that one either, so I'll fix that one again manually. There may be a few spots here and there where you're manually fixing these things one frame at a time. That one worked out pretty well. That one worked out well. So let me zoom out and cross my fingers and see if I can get a longer track again with track forward. Okay, I got a few more frames, but I've still got some issues in here. So I think I'm gonna run into a few more issues like this throughout the course of the shot. What I recommend doing is just kind of, you know, taking it one piece at a time as best you can. I'm gonna fast forward through a lot of the rest of this tracking section here so we can get on to the rest of the process. Here's a spot toward the end of the shot where the problem I'm running into is her hair is actually crossing over that feature, that darker spot on the earbud that I'm trying to track. So I'm having to figure out where that is manually until I can get that clear of her hair, at least mostly. I'm trying to make a bunch of manual corrections in here. And I hope from here on out I can finish this track without any other issues. Her whole angle turns away from us here toward the end of the shot as well, so it also makes it a bit more difficult, but I think we're gonna leave this as it is. For this version, I want that feature to stay in the center of the frame the entire time, so I'm gonna use the stabilize feature in HitFilm. Normally with stabilization, you have 2 points to track to correct things like rotation, but it also works just fine with a single point track. In the track tab, change the purpose to stabilize and click apply. Return to the viewer panel, expand the transform controls, and notice that HitFilm has added keyframes to the anchor point property. By changing the anchor point over time, the image effectively moves around that tracked feature. Now for the zoom. One way is to change the scale property of the footage layer. For example, setting the scale to 200% will enlarge it enough to take its edges out of the frame. Normally I wouldn't want to scale footage that large, but if my project is 1080p, it all balances out in the end. However, another method would be to leave the scale at 100% and change the comp settings to 1920 by 1080, which effectively crops in on a smaller part of the original. In the end, use whichever method makes the most sense depending on the resolution of your footage compared to your project. Looking at the end result, the technique works really well, but there are clearly some issues with this particular clip. Let's go through that checklist we talked about earlier. Resolution? Well, it's a 4K clip, and the cropped or zoomed version looks pretty good, so in theory, we're good there, but let's keep going. Shutter speed? Considering this was shot outside in bright sunlight, you'd think the shutter speed would be pretty high, but we still got some blurry spots here and there. Shutter speed may be partly to blame for that, but I feel the biggest problem is an unsteady camera. Let's look at the original again. With the camera going all over, especially at the beginning of the shot, some parts are tough to use because the earbuds end up very close to the top of the frame. You could scale the footage up to compensate, but the more you scale, the softer the footage becomes. To avoid needing to scale so much, keep your camera steady. As it is, we've got a couple seconds here and there that might work for a quick cut commercial, but not much if we want long stretches of action. For our second sample, we're going to use this clip. We're going to start with it full frame, zoom in and track some feature on the camera, then pull back out to full frame again. We're going to start with tracking, of course, the same process as when we tracked the earbuds. Add a track. Move the tracking markers into place, in this case over the camera's flash plate, and set their size. Once that's done, we will track forward. This clip tracked without any issues, however, the ending feature position is off-center a bit. Because the focus is best at the end of the shot, I'm going to redo the track backwards. Remove the keyframes from feature offset and feature position. This will leave the feature and search boxes untouched. If I delete the track, I'd have to move them back into position again. Adjust the feature and search areas, then use the track back option. I think I like this track better overall. Next, make a point layer and name it something like tracking point. Select the tracking point layer from the layer dropdown in the track tab and click apply. That takes all the position data and applies it to the point layer. Back in the viewer, you can see the point layer moving around and following the flash plate. Now decide when you want the camera to push in on the feature you tracked. I'm gonna go with this frame here. Select and delete all keyframes on the point layer before that frame. do the same thing for the end. Because of how things are moving in this footage, I think I want this to be my end. For this example, I want the transitions in and out to take 15 frames. So I'll start with the time marker on the point layer's last keyframe, press Shift Period once to advance 10 frames, then tap the period key 5 more times, which puts us 15 frames from the end, and set the X and Y values to 0. Select this new keyframe plus the one 15 frames before it and set their interpolation to manual Bezier. Move back to the start of the shot and do the reverse. Beginning with the time marker on the point layer's first keyframe, move back 15 frames by pressing Shift comma once, then tap the comma key 5 times, and set the X and Y values to 0. Select this new keyframe plus the one 15 frames after it and set their interpolation to manual Bezier. With those changes done, the point layer now starts in the center of the frame, shifts to follow the feature, then back to the center again. Click this icon here to convert the point layer to 3D, and then do the same for the footage layer. With the time marker at the start of the shot, parent the camera layer to the point layer. Because the point layer starts in the center, follows a feature, and then returns to the center again, the camera now does the same thing. Now we'll add some zoom keyframes on the camera. Expand the camera's properties, then expand the lens category. Move the time marker to match the first keyframe on the point layer. Now a tip for this is to select the position property for the point layer, then press Alt or Option and the comma and period keys until the time marker is on that first keyframe. Then activate keyframes for the zoom property. Advance 15 frames, then increase the zoom until the edges are totally hidden. Change the interpolation for both keyframes to manual Bezier. Now move the time marker to the last keyframe, where the point is following the feature. Again, select the point layer's position property, then Alt or Option and the comma and period keys to find the right frame. Select the camera's zoom property and press Alt or Option T, which will add a keyframe at the current value. Advance 15 frames, select the first zoom keyframe, press Ctrl or Command C to copy it, then Ctrl or Command V to paste it. Change the interpolation for both keyframes to manual Bezier. And that's it. Let's review that checklist again and see how it turned out. Even though it's 1080p footage, it's still pretty clear after a slight push in, and the original camera motion was smooth enough that the shutter speed isn't a problem. So with this one, we are all good. So there you have it. Two techniques for tracking and following features, and that, my friends, is just the beginning. You know what? You can even take parts of both of these ideas and combine them for something totally different. Give it a shot. Anyway, be sure to subscribe for more HitFilm goodness, and until next time... Seriously, you couldn't just let this end cleanly, could you?